In this lecture, we will address keywords related to the test process topic. These keywords are the keywords which we are going to cover in this lecture because they are related to the upcoming topics. I will cover a few now, and the remaining I will cover while addressing the topic. These are the 8 keywords you must know before we go to the test process topic. All the definitions provided here are given by ISTQB itself. Along with the definition, I will provide some real examples for easy understanding of these terms. So let's get started with the keywords. The first keyword is test basis, and it is defined as the body of knowledge used as the basis for test analysis and design. In simple terms, test basis is nothing but the requirement. Let's see an example to understand this. Suppose this is the requirement. We need a light system which will glow when the door is open and close when the door is closed. The system should work like mentioned. This is a requirement which we need to test, and it is referred to as test basis. So remember, whenever you hear test basis, it's nothing but a requirement. Now let's see the second keyword, test condition. It is defined as a testable aspect of a component or system identified as a basis for testing. Let's refer to the same example to find out a testable aspect of the requirement. The testable aspects are: light shall glow when the door is open. The light shall not glow when the door is closed. After reading the test basis, we got this as a testable condition. So, in simple terms, test conditions are testable requirements obtained for the test basis. The next keyword is a test case, and it is defined as a set of preconditions, inputs, actions, where applicable, expected results, and postconditions developed based on test conditions. In simple words, test cases are a set of actions to test the test condition. Let's continue with our example to understand this point. Now, to check these test conditions, we can write 2 test cases as shown here. Test case 1 is switch on power, open door, check light on, switch off power. And test case 2 is switch on power, close door, check light off, switch off power. With these 2 test cases, we can test the test conditions. What you should remember is, action to evaluate test condition is called test cases. The next keyword is test procedure, and it is defined as a sequence of test cases in execution order, and any associated actions that may be required to set up the initial preconditions and any wrap-up activities post-execution. This term is used mostly when you go for manual testing, where you decide in which order test cases are to be executed, or if any precondition or postconditions are required. Now let's have a look into test case 1. After the test case is executed, the door shall be closed and light to be switched off. Similarly, for test case 2, during the initial condition, the door should be open and light must be on so that we can see the change. The next keyword is test data, and it is defined as data needed for test execution. This term is used during the automation testing while executing the test case. We need test data, which we can provide as an input to the test cases. Let's see the sample data to understand this point. In the test case, we are saying switch on the power supply, but we didn't mention how much voltage should be provided. This data we will get from test data. Similarly, all other values are stored. This data can be stored in Excel form or any testing-specific tools. Let's move to the next keyword, which is test suite, And it is defined as a set of test scripts or test procedures to be executed in a specific test run. By using the test case as a reference, test scripts are developed using any of the scripting languages, such as JavaScript or Python. These test scripts are then arranged in the execution order as shown here. That's why we can say a group of test scripts with a sequence of instructions is called test suite. The next keyword is testware. It is defined as work products produced during the test process for use in planning, designing, executing, evaluating, and reporting on testing. As we know, we have different activities in the test process, like test planning, test monitoring, test analysis, test design, test implementation, test execution, and test closure. Each of these activities provide an output. These outputs are called testware. Testware is stored for each testing phase for future reference. The last key point is test oracle. It is defined as a source to determine an expected result to compare with the actual result of the system under test. As the definition says, test oracle stores expected results, which is compared against the measured result during test execution. These were the 8 keywords which we covered here, and it will be very helpful for you as we cover the following topics. Now let's summarize the points. Test bases are defined as the body of knowledge used as the basis for test analysis and design. In simple terms, test basis is nothing but the requirement. The test condition is defined as a testable aspect of a component or system identified as a basis for testing. The test case is defined as a set of preconditions, inputs, actions, where applicable, expected results, and postconditions developed based on test conditions. The test procedure is defined as a sequence of test cases in execution order, and any associated actions that may be required to set up the initial preconditions and any wrap-up activities post-execution. Test suite is defined as a set of test scripts or test procedures to be executed in a specific test run. Test data is defined as data needed for test execution. Testware is defined as work products produced during the test process for use in planning, designing, executing, evaluating, and reporting on testing. Test oracle is defined as a source to determine an expected result to compare with the actual result of the system under test.